But in terms of this issue of privatization, how many people, be honest with me, how many people in this room have heard of a family called the Koch brothers, K-O-C-H? Good, very good. All right, this is what you don't know about the Koch brothers. What you see in the media is they will say that the Koch brothers are a very wealthy family, and they are. They're worth, I think, between $90 and $100 billion. And you're going to hear that the Koch brothers are going to spend a lot of money supporting right-wing Republicans in the elections, and it's true. The Koch brothers and a few of their billionaire friends will be spending $400 million in the coming midterm elections. You got that? One family going to spend $400 million in the coming election with a few of their billionaire friends. But what you don't hear about is what do these guys stand? Okay, they're very, very rich. They spend a lot of money to elect Republicans. Okay, big deal. What do they stand for? Who knows what they stand for? Now that's where they get their money. They're into fossil fuel, among other things. What do they want? Why are they spending so much money? What's their goal?
Greed and corruption.
Yeah, but more than that. Who knows? Yeah, back there. Yes, sir.
The end of liberal democracy, basically.
Yeah, something like that. Well, what does that mean? Okay, here we go.
All right.
Since the 1930s, for your parents or grandparents in the 1920s, in the early part of this country, if you were old and you were sick and you didn't have a lot of money, what happened to you?
Poor farms.
Poor farms.
That's right. You may have gone to the poor farms. You may have been able to get some charity. Oh, you died. The truth is, before Social Security, you know, we forget about these things. We don't learn about them. Young people don't know it. Before we had Social Security, about half of the elderly people in this country lived in poverty. And before you had Medicare, passed in the 1960s under Lyndon Johnson, when people got old and sick, they were in desperate condition. So what has happened in this country over the last 70, 80 years is there was a transformation of government, starting with FDR in 1932. Basically, what that transformation was about, which said, you know, Dennis raised the issue of the minimum wage. There was a time in America where an employer could pay a worker anything that employer wanted to pay. And people said, well, that's crazy. We cannot have people working for starvation wages. We need at least a minimum wage. And we established the minimum wage. Government said people can't work in factories where they're losing their fingers or their hands. We need certain safety regulations. Government said we can't have factories dumping crap into rivers and lakes or polluting the air where people are getting sick. We need to regulate the environment. We need to pass Social Security so that when people get old, at least they have some regular guaranteed source of income coming in. We need senior health care. We need health care for poor people, called Medicaid, etc., etc. What the Koch brothers are about is a very right-wing ideology and philosophy, which basically says that government is bad and that we have to get government out of all of the aspects of our lives where progress has been made over the last 70 or 80 years. So they won't say this publicly, but in truth, they don't want to cut Social Security. They want to eliminate Social Security. They want to eliminate Medicare and Medicaid. They are saying their idea of freedom. See, they talk about freedom. So if you're old and you're sick, you will have the freedom to go to any private insurance company you want. And if you're old, you can get your retirement benefits from Wall Street or anybody else. But they do not want government playing a role in protecting the elderly, the children, the sick, the poor, or working families. That is their philosophy. And over the years, because they spend so much money and they're so powerful, they have think tanks. When you watch television, some economist gets up there and says, well, this is why I think tax breaks for billionaires are a good idea. You don't know that that economist works for a think tank funded by the Koch brothers. In fact, there are political scientists who will tell you what I believe is true. Democratic Party, very powerful. Republican Party, very powerful. The Koch brothers are even more powerful. They spend more money, in politics that either the Democratic or Republican National Committees will spend. And that is their ideology. So what you see when you see people in Congress, Republican leaders, Paul Ryan, saying we got to throw 30 million people off of health insurance, this is part of what the Koch brothers are about. They don't believe government should provide health insurance for anybody. We talk about, hear about people talking about privatizing Social Security. That's what we're talking about. So that takes us to the VA. Now, the VA is the largest integrated healthcare system in this country. I am not going to sit here and tell you that the VA is perfect. It is not. But I'm not going to tell you that any healthcare system or any hospital is perfect as well. I am the former chairman of the Senate Committee on Veterans Affairs. So I have talked to all of the major veterans organizations, the American Legion, the DAV, the VFW, the Vietnam Vets, you name them. And what they will tell you is that once people get into the veterans healthcare system, by and large, they are very happy with the care they get. And one of the best medical centers in the country happens to be in White River Junction. And what we have done here in Vermont over the past few years is expand community-based outreach to Newport, to Brattleboro, as well. So we now have 5 community-based outreach clinics. So there are those people led by the Koch brothers who are saying, you got a $200 billion budget for the VA. Think about how much money private corporations can make out of that system if we privatize it. That's their goal. And I'm going to do everything that I can to prevent that from happening. Now, this guy, Dr. Shulkin, who you may remember, was fired by Trump a couple of weeks ago. That is exactly what the issue is. I disagree with Shulkin on some things. But he was very clear. He did not want to move to privatize the VA the way the Trump administration did. And they got rid of him.